when I read the speech the first time, I thought, wow. For me, it was like, is this going to make sense with the rest of the movie?
So I came over from Dublin and did my show yesterday, got on the flight, went straight to Warner and watched the movie, then got into a taxi and he turned around and he was like, why are you crying? And I was like, I don't know.
Oh, I love that. That's how I felt after I read the script. I was like, I'm laughing, I'm crying. What is this feeling? I don't even know all the feelings I'm feeling.
It's going to take a lot of people by surprise, isn't it? I don't think people understand what it's about until you actually sit on the seat. Do you feel it's going to be like that?
Yeah, you know, I guess I hadn't realized because, you know, I read it almost 2 years ago and I've known how special it is and I've been so excited for people to see it. And I guess I hadn't realized how, from the outside, you don't really know what it's about. I mean, there's been so many images and so many memes and so much marketing, but I guess people, you know, don't really know what the movie is. And I feel like that's fun. It's fun that people get to watch a big movie and that there are still surprises in it.
Isn't it great that everyone's jumped on board with it? Like, it's just, it has been this massive train of, you know, Barbie's coming, Barbie's coming, Barbie's coming, and now it's finally here. Yeah. Have you been keeping an eye on that and kind of giving it kind of like a little kind of glint going, oh, I'm in this?
Yeah, I mean, like I said, you know, ever since I read the script, it feels like having a little secret, you know, like getting to be a part of a little secret. And it's just been so exciting to, I've never been a part of anything so highly anticipated before. And yet, people don't actually know what the movie is. And so I'm really excited for it to be in the world, for people to see it, and then to see what that creates, you know, what conversations and thoughts and what that does culturally once people have experienced the movie.
So you have the speech. So for people who have watched this, when they're watching this now, they've obviously watched the movie, your speech in it, like when you read that for the first time, what did you see anyone around you when you were acting it out? Because I was watching people beside me and like there were a couple of lads and girls and they were getting uncomfortable as in, wow, this is like a movement. Did you feel like that when you read it out the first time?
Yeah, when I read the speech the first time, I thought, wow, that's like, it's a gift as an actor. And it's also intimidating to really give any kind of monologue or speech where you have to, you know, talk for that long and also, you know, make it feel new and fresh. I mean, I did that speech probably like between 30 and 40 times, like when we filmed it. So, you know, Greta and I talked about it a lot. There was definitely like a buildup to that in the filming process. And when I did it, it was definitely a feeling on set of like everyone kind of getting grounded in this truth. And I felt it from the crew and I felt it from the cast. And it really was this moment of like, for me, it was like, is this going to make sense with the rest of the movie? I'm like, because the movie is so like fun and bright and, you know, and here's this moment of like the real world crashing.
It glued it together,
in.
I found. It glued the whole thing together.
Yeah. And you know, I feel like I just had so much faith in Greta and I knew that like, she knew what she was looking for. She knew what it was supposed to feel like. I felt like she trusted me. She gave me so much space to play. And like I could play because she knew what she was after. And she was going to make it all make sense. And I feel like she did.
Were you there for the days when they were doing, hi Barbie, hi Ken, over and over again? The guys were telling me.
Yeah, I feel like I was there for hi Barbie, hi Ken days, for sure. I was there for a lot of days that I wasn't actually in front of the camera. Greta actually invited me to shadow her as a director. I'm directing my first feature film in the coming year, and Greta knew that, and she basically just invited me to like shadow her and watch her prep and direct. And it was such a joy to be on set on days that I wasn't in front of the camera so that I could sit back and take it all in and really see this incredible thing come together and how Greta was, you know, the master of this vision.
There's an Irish phrase of saying there's a turn in somebody And it feels like there's that in Greta, that from everyone who I've been speaking to today, that she has this goodwill for people, or she feels like she's the step for people. What you've just said there kind of just kind of says that she has that for people, like allowing you to do something like that.
Yeah, I think that Greta is a genuine lover of creativity, a lover of making films and telling stories. And so, you know, when she invites you to play, it's like you can't help but be swept up in how much she loves the process. And it's like everything is, it's like serious fun. It's like we're all here to have fun, serious, like in a serious way.
Serious messing.
Yeah.